Hi, I'm Ben, and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm gonna be talking about 6 skincare products that I love for helping to improve uneven skin tone. Okay, so for today's video, I'm just gonna jump right into the products because I love all 6 of these products so much. Whether you are struggling with uneven skin tone from like post-acne marks or redness or hyperpigmentation, all of these products can be really, really, really useful for that and helping to just boost overall like evenness and glowiness of your complexion. So I'm very excited about all of these products and I'm gonna break down today's video kind of by ingredients and I'm gonna talk about kind of the key ingredient that's bringing this benefit of helping to even out skin tone and then the products that I love that feature those ingredients. So let's get right into it. The first ingredient that I want to talk about is one that has been so popular recently, so I'm sure that many of you have tried products that contain it, and that is niacinamide. Niacinamide is an amazing ingredient. If you're not familiar with it, I did do a bite-sized episode on niacinamide. It's less than 5 minutes, just talks about like what niacinamide is, what it does for the skin. One of the key benefits of niacinamide is that it helps to improve overall skin tone. So it helps to even out skin tone and correct signs of redness, discoloration, etc. But the benefit of niacinamide is that it's much gentler than a lot of other ingredients that can contribute to overall skin tone, because while it contributes to overall skin tone, it simultaneously helps to strengthen the skin barrier. It's really great for helping to soothe the skin, and it can also help to improve texture with things like pore size, oil production, bumpiness. All of these things can be helped with niacinamide. So it's just a really good ingredient for the skin, and the niacinamide product that I love is the Glossier Super Pure. This is a really, really nice serum. It's niacinamide, zinc, and sodium PCA as kind of the hero ingredients. So this one grabbed my attention because the product that I really feel like kind of brought niacinamide onto the map is the Ordinary 10% Niacinamide Plus Zinc. This product gained so much popularity, it's changed so many people's skin and people swear by it. So I of course was really eager and tried it out of like a few years ago when it was first becoming really popular, and it didn't work for me. I actually had really bad breakouts, I had a really bad reaction to it, and I started to think that maybe I just like couldn't do niacinamide, maybe my skin didn't like it. But looking at the ingredients of other products that I used, especially K-beauty products that I was using at the time, a lot of them had niacinamide in them. It wasn't like the hero ingredient that was advertised, but I realized that I didn't have like an allergy or something to niacinamide. It was really just that specific product. And so I wanted to find one that had a lower concentration of niacinamide and find something a little bit more gentle for my skin. So I looked and I looked and I looked and I didn't really find any that I loved. And then I found this one from Glossier. And to be honest, I hadn't even looked at Glossier because I'm not gonna lie, I just didn't really take Glossier skincare very seriously, but I saw somewhere pretty recently, I think it was like 1.5 years ago, I saw a thing that they had reformulated some of their super serums. So just out of curiosity, I looked at Super Pure and I was blown away. The formula is so beautiful. It's so simple and mild and gentle, and just the ingredients overall are amazing. So it has niacinamide at 5% concentration, which is really good because it's effective, but it's still really gentle. It also combines it with the zinc, like in the Ordinary niacinamide and zinc. Zinc is a great ingredient for kind of overall skin health, and I did really like that they incorporated that into the formula as well. And then it also has sodium PCA, which is an amazing ingredient for helping to bind moisture in the skin. So overall, it's just a great niacinamide product. I see such drastic improvement in my skin tone when I use this, and it's also just really gentle. It's hydrating, it's soothing, it's just a beautiful product overall. So if you're like me and you're looking for kind of a gentler niacinamide alternative, this one from Glossier is really amazing. The other product that I love that has niacinamide, and it's kind of perfect because it also contains another ingredient that I want to talk about. So just like, it's such a multitasker, and I talk about it in a ton of my videos, and it's the Benton Snail Bee High Content Skin. If you've been watching my videos for like any amount of time, you're definitely familiar with this product. It's my favorite toner, and part of the reason that I talk about it so frequently is because it has so many benefits. It's hydrating, so I talk about it for dry skin. It's great for people with acne-prone skin, so I talk about it a lot in that context. But it also has niacinamide, and it's great for helping to improve overall skin tone. So this is just a great product for if you're struggling with skin tone, because it has that niacinamide, which is obviously a great ingredient for skin tone, but it combines it with snail mucin. And snail mucin is another ingredient that is amazing for skin tone concerns because it's a natural source of glycolic acid. So Glycolic acid is an AHA, it's an exfoliant alpha hydroxy acid. At the same time, snail mucin also helps to hydrate the skin, helps to plump the skin, it's a natural source of hyaluronic acid as well. It's really just an incredible, incredible ingredient for tone, for texture, for the strength of your skin barrier. It's such a good ingredient. So mixing the snail mucin with the niacinamide, like in this formula, is just amazing. And when I'm struggling with any sort of discoloration or any sort of just like my skin tone is a little bit off, this is a product that I always find myself reaching for. So it's a great, great, great option. And so then from that product, I wanna talk about kind of those two ingredients, snail mucin and then specifically glycolic acid. So snail mucin in general is just an amazing ingredient for skin tone. And if you want a snail mucin product but aren't as focused on like the niacinamide, or you just wanna really get something that is like snail mucin, this one from COSRX, the Advanced Snail 96 Mucin Power Essence, is amazing. So this is 96% snail mucin, and it's amazing. This is like the one of the first Korean skincare essences that I ever used. And it's one of the brands and products that really got me into K-beauty years ago when I was first working at SoCoGlam. And this is like an OG. If you've been in the K-beauty game for a little while, you definitely know this one. It's been around for a long time. And I swear by this one, I absolutely love it. And so many other people do as well. The amount of stories that I hear about this product helping with acne scarring, discoloration, just like overall skin tone concerns, it's so good. And it's also so hydrating, so plumping. It's great for helping to strengthen and nourish the skin and just helping to improve that overall skin tone. So if you're looking for like a snail mucin specific product, this is like my go-to. They sent this to me and it was such a like pinch me moment, because like I said, COSRX was one of the first brands and this was one of the first products that got me into K-beauty. And so to like, you know, kind of have a relationship with the brand and get this product from them now and not have to buy it with my own money anymore, it's just like so full circle, and like it's such a pinch me moment. So I love this essence and highly, highly, highly recommend if you're looking for a snail mucin product. And then on the other side is if you're looking for glycolic acid. So like I said, snail mucin is great because you get some of those incremental benefits of glycolic acid, which is an alpha hydroxy acid, but it's not gonna be as potent or efficacious as a synthetic, you know, pure potent glycolic acid. And so if you're looking for those benefits, I don't ever want you to think that like putting snail mucin on your skin is gonna deliver the same, you know, level of results. So if you're looking for like a pure glycolic, I love the Crave Beauty Kalaluya. This is such a beautiful formula, and glycolic acid is one of the best ingredients for helping to even out skin tone because it's an alpha hydroxy acid, so it has a slightly larger molecular size than a beta hydroxy acid like a salicylic acid, which means that its exfoliation is a little bit more on the surface of the skin. This makes it really, really effective for more surface level concerns like tone and texture. So whether you're trying to even out your skin tone from like discoloration or some like red post acne marks or something like that, or if you're struggling with skin texture as well, it's a great ingredient for both of those concerns. And just overall, alpha hydroxy acids in general, but especially glycolic acid, really promote like a glowy, radiant, even skin tone. The downside of alpha hydroxy acids is that they can be really irritating. And so I see a lot of products on the market with glycolic acid at like 10, 15, 20% concentrations, and it is way too strong for my skin. I can't use those products. And similarly to how I felt with niacinamide, I thought for a while that I just like couldn't use glycolic acid and that my skin just didn't respond well to it. And then I found this one. This one has 5.25% glycolic acid, so it is much gentler than a lot of other glycolic acid products on the market. And the formula is also really, really beautiful, as well as the glycolic. It also has kale, hyaluronic acid, aloe, vitamin B5. So as well as this really efficacious exfoliant in the form of glycolic acid, you also get these ingredients that are rich in nutrients for the skin. They help to hydrate and soothe. And so it's such a nice formula. And it's so much gentler than a lot of other glycolic acid products out there. And so I love it, especially if I've had any like breakouts recently and I'm struggling with like red marks or red patches after having some breakouts that are kind of throwing off my overall skin tone. This is the product that I reach for. It is so effective and it's way gentler than a lot of other ones. I still would not recommend this for like daily use. I would say like 1 to 3 nights a week is pretty much the sweet spot. I also love Crave because they like responsibly label their exfoliant, and they say in the instructions, well, you probably can't really read that, but it says 2 to 3 times per week, which I see a lot of brands like label their exfoliants that it's suitable for daily use, even 2 or 3 times daily use, which I really do not agree with. I don't think you should be exfoliating your skin every day. So I love that Crave has labeled this in a more responsible manner. And using this glycolic 1 or 2, maybe 3 times a week is such a great option for helping to improve overall skin tone. Okay, and then the last ingredient that I want to talk about is a superstar for overall skin tone and just like helping to promote a more even, glowy, radiant complexion kind of just overall, and that is vitamin C. Vitamin C is incredible. It comes in a lot of different forms. I personally like to use ascorbic acid because ascorbic acid is the most well-researched and the most well-studied form of vitamin C and arguably the most effective form of vitamin C. But some of the other vitamin C derivatives that are coming onto the market are showing a lot of promise, and there are definitely other vitamin C derivatives that can be really effective, but my personal preference is ascorbic acid. And when it comes to vitamin C, it's all about finding the one that works well for you. If you've never used vitamin C before, the first vitamin C that I ever used was the Claire's Freshly Juiced Vitamin Drop, or maybe it's Freshly Squeezed Vitamin Drop. Either Freshly Juiced or Freshly Squeezed Vitamin Drop, whichever one it is an amazing, amazing serum. And I don't have it with me now because I'm using another one at the moment, but it was the first one that I used. Its concentration of vitamin C is 5%, which is a lot lower than a lot of other serums on the market, which means it's a lot gentler. And it's a great vitamin C if you've never used vitamin C before and you're just kind of easing into it, but it's also so effective. Even to this day, as I've been using vitamin C for quite a while now, I still find myself getting a bottle of the Claire's every now and again and just using that one because I love it, and it leaves my skin so glowy and like even, and it's just a beautiful, beautiful formula. So that's always kind of the one that I recommend for people that have never tried vitamin C before. I think it's a great intro, and even if you tried vitamin C and you've been using it for a while but you're just looking for one that's more gentle and kind of, you know, a little bit, you know, a little more mild on the skin, that Claire's one is amazing. The one that I'm currently using is the Good Skin Days Seize the Day Serum. So this one I love. It has vitamin C at 10% concentration, and it is ascorbic acid, which is my favorite form. And 10% is a great, great, great concentration in my mind because it is very effective. It's a very potent product, and I really do see these incredible benefits of the vitamin C, but it's still gentler than a lot of other vitamin C's on the market. This is one of the gentlest vitamin C's that I've used. This one and the Claire's, they're both just so gentle and nice on the skin. And this one is nice because it also has niacinamide in the formula. So you get these skin tone evening benefits of both the vitamin C and the niacinamide. And this combo for me, I find really, really, really helps to promote an overall more even skin tone and complexion. Vitamin C is also incredible because it's an antioxidant, so it really helps to protect against free radical damage. And this one is also formulated with Camu Camu, which is also really rich in antioxidants. So that combination of the vitamin C and the niacinamide is amazing for helping to improve overall skin tone. And then that combination of the vitamin C and the Camu Camu is amazing for those antioxidant, skin strengthening, skin protecting benefits. So I love this one. The one drawback of the serum in my mind is that it does oxidize more quickly, I would say, than a lot of other vitamin C's that I've tried. What I mean when I say oxidize is that the serum starts, oh my gosh, I shouldn't open it because it's more air exposure, but I'm gonna do it for y'all. The serum is clear, if this will focus. Let me put my thumb behind it. There we go. So the serum is clear, hopefully you can see that. And what happens when it oxidizes is that the serum starts to turn more of like a yellowish, orangey brown color. And that oxidation is a sign that the serum is losing its efficacy and its potency. Vitamin C is notoriously difficult to formulate with. It's very difficult to stabilize. The vast majority of vitamin C serums do start to oxidize after a while, and the shelf life is very much dependent on the packaging and the formula. This one, I find, does oxidize relatively quickly. What this means for me is that when I'm using this vitamin C serum, it is the only vitamin C serum that I'm using, and I use it every single morning. When I use it in that manner, I find that I get through the product quickly enough that it's not an issue. But if you're someone that doesn't like to use vitamin C every day, like maybe you use it every other day, or maybe just a few times a week, or you're just like, you have a couple vitamin C's that you love and you don't want to just commit to just one, then I probably would not recommend this one for you because it will probably go bad before you can get through it. I find that when I use it every single day, every single morning, that's what I need to do in order order to get through it before it turns. I'm really hoping that they're gonna improve the formula and improve the stability of it, but I'm also cognizant of the fact that a lot of the time, the ingredients that allow vitamin C to be fully stabilized are pretty harsh and they can be pretty irritating. And so I think that that trade-off is that like this serum is really gentle, but it also does oxidize a little bit more quickly. So that's one downside of it. It's not a perfect product by any means, but it is still my favorite vitamin C at the moment. And I find that when I use it daily, I get through it in time. So just important to keep in mind depending on how you use vitamin C. Okay, and then the last category of product that I want to talk about is kind of just an honorable mention because it's sunscreen. If you're struggling with skin tone and just like overall evenness of your complexion, sunscreen is the most important product. And I'm saying it as an honorable mention because we should all be wearing sunscreen every single day no matter what, but especially if your concern is skin tone, any unprotected exposure to the sun is just going to exacerbate those concerns, whether it's dark spots, redness, any sort of discoloration or irregularities in your skin tone, the sun is just going to make it worse. So having a good sunscreen is key. Currently, I cycle through different sunscreens. If you watch my videos, you know there are a few that I like, but the one that I have been using the most recently is the Pipette Mineral Sunscreen. I love this one. It's a baby sunscreen, so it's really, really, really gentle. It's 100% mineral filters. It uses 20% zinc oxide. It is really, really hydrating on the skin. So for me with dry skin, I love it. It has a very dewy, moisturized finish. It has squalane in it, which is amazing for helping to hydrate the skin. And it's nice because a lot of mineral sunscreens can feel kind of drying on the skin, and this one is the opposite. It feels very moisturizing, very nourishing. Probably would not recommend it for oily skin, but if you're on the drier side like I am, it's an awesome sunscreen. But it is mineral, so if you're someone that struggles with white cast from zinc oxide, it is important to keep in mind that this is just 20% zinc oxide. That's the only sunscreen filter that it uses. So it might not be suitable for you if you're someone that struggles a lot with white cast, in which case looking more for like a chemical sunscreen is probably your better option. The biggest thing is that you're wearing sunscreen every single day, especially if like evenness of skin tone is important for you. So those are all the products that I wanted to talk about. And when it comes to uneven skin tone, just thinking about these ingredients like niacinamide, snail mucin, glycolic acid, vitamin C, good sun protection. These are all great ingredients for helping to improve just overall evenness of your skin tone and just a good, even, glowy complexion. I love all of these products for this. If you have any questions about any of the products or the ingredients that I mentioned, always feel free to leave those in the comment section down below. I always love to see comments from all of you. And I hope that you enjoyed this video and found it helpful, useful, informative, entertaining, hopefully all the above. If you did, feel free to leave a like and subscribe, and I'll see you next time for my next video. Thanks so much for tuning in. Bye.